Okay, this is a short presentation of the DICE program handling. We'll start here by showing how the final program runs, and it's very simple. For the first three lines, we have with 30 dice thrown, and you can have the mean sum first, and the median, and the standard deviation. The three lines here shows the mean with 5 dice, the median with 5 dice, and the standard deviation with 5 dice. And the last two lines here, we have the t value between 4 dice and 5 dice, and where it determines if there is a significant difference or not. So, that's rather simple. See, in this case, there isn't. So, on to the code. Alright. To begin with, I have these 5 prototype functions here. I got the dice function, which calculates dice rolls. I got the mean, which calculates the mean of the dice roll sums. And then I have the median, which is not enough the median, and I got the standard deviation and the t-test. Okay, to begin with here, I have a constant, which is Einstein short, called rolls, which is 30. It's what I use to determine the size of my arrays, and also the reason it's 30 is because it has each have to roll 30 times with both 4 and 5 dice. Next, you got 3 arrays here. The first array is to store the sums of each row, and it's used in a fairly good amount of the functions here. It's in the dice, using the dice function, the mean, the median, and the standard deviation here. The row A4 is used to store the entry sums for the rows with 4 sums, with 4 dice, sorry, and it's only used in the t-test. And likewise, the row A5 is used to store the sums with the 5 dice, and it's also only used in the t-test, apart from in the main. Next here, I have an unsigned short called n dice, which is the amount of dice with right dice is rolled. And next here, I got some floats. The mean final is used to store the mean for the entries sums here, and is used in the mean function and the standard deviation function. And mean 4 and 5 is used to store the means for 4 dice and 5 dice, and is used in the t-test. STDDEV final is used in the STDDEV function, and is used to store the standard deviation for the dice rolls. And the STDDEV 4 and 5 is used to store the standard deviation for 4 fine dice in the t-test. And here we have seeding the random function, which is used in the dice test to work out the random numbers. Okay. And here I have a while loop. It only loops as while n dice is equal 4 or 5, and if n dice is 4, it rolls this. It goes through this. First, it goes through the dice function here, which starts out by creating a chart dice roll here, which is used to store the roll for each dice. And then I have a unsigned short, which stores the sum for each roll with either 4 or 5 dice. So here I have a double for loop, and in the inner loop I have a dice roll which is equal to, random number with modulus 6, and then add 1 to get a range of 1 to 6. And once this has happened, it adds this number to the dice sum, and it goes through this either 4 or 5 times depending on the value of n dice. Once this has happened, it adds a dice sum into the entry of the array here, and resets the dice sum. This does 30 times here, as I have rolls here, which are 30. Next, I have a for loop here, which puts each entry, which in the roll array 4, equal to the corresponding entry in roll array. And next, I have C out here, which prints that the mean dice for 4 is, and then it runs the function mean. And the mean function here starts out by creating a float here, which is called mean sum and is set equal to 0. And then for each entry in the array, it adds this value of that entry into the mean sum, and then also find the mean, which is the mean final here. I take the mean sum and divide it by the amount of rolls here, so I get the mean. And finally, I print out the value for mean final. And once this is done, I set mean forward to be equal to mean final. And then I print out this text here, which is the median with four dice is, and I run the median function. And here I create a temporary array, which is rows long, which were 30. Then I have a for loop here, which populates the temporary array to be with each entry to be equal to the corresponding array, entry in the row array. Then I have a double for loop here, where the inner for loop checks if the current entry is larger than the following entry, and if it is, it swaps these two entries. This for loop has run through 15 times in order to make sure that in order to get the temporary array to begin at the lowest entry and end at the highest entry, and go from there. So once this has happened, I print out the 14th entry in a temporary, which is the median with when I have 30 entries, and yeah, that's it for the median. Once this has happened, I print out again here, standard deviation for 5 dice is, and run the stdev function. In here, I create a float called stdev sum. And in a for loop, I take every entry in the array divided by the mean for the array, for the total mean, to the power of 2, and adds that to the current sum of the current value of the stdev sum. And once this has happened, I find a standard deviation. I take a square root of stdev sum and divide it by mean final. So here I have the standard deviation, which I then print out here. So, once I've calculated the standard deviation for here, I set the stdev 4 to be equal to stdev final. And in this part here, by setting n dice to be equal to 5. And then when it runs through again, it actually just does the same as before, except it's with 5 dice now. And then it sets n dice to 0, which ends the while loop here. Once the while loop has finished running, it runs the t-test function here, which is to determine if it's significantly different or not. Oh, sorry about that. And here I create the float t value, and next I set t value to be equal to the mean 5 subtracted by mean 4 divided by the square root of std 5 to the power of 2 plus std 4 to the power of 2. And once this is done, if t value is less than 2.045, I print out that the t value, that there is no significant difference between using 4 or 5 dice, and if it's greater than 2.05, I print out that there's a significant difference between 4 or 5 dice. And the reason it's 2.015 is because this table here, when I have the degree of freedom of 28, which I have because I got 30 entries and 2 groups, so I have 30 subtracted by 2, which is 28, and I have a probability of 5% here, and get a value of 2.05. So, that's basically it. I'm just gonna run it one more time for the final time, and that will pretty much be it. So yeah, see, this time it's no significant difference, but it happens from time to time. Yeah, that's it.